good evening, and welcome to the Whitewater Wind Down. I'm Edie Frenay alongside Peyton Walls.
Spring break is this week, and I am so excited to get out of here. I'm looking forward to my mom's home-cooked meals. Not saying the food on campus isn't great or anything, but I could really use a home-cooked meal right now.
I totally get it. I like being on campus, and I like leaving, I like going home, and I like coming back, you know, but certain times of the day, I'm just like, man, what I wouldn't do for a home-cooked deviled egg right now.
For real. My mom makes the best tortellini soup in the world. If I could just, like, I'm really excited to leave so I can have some home-cooked meals. But anyways, I'm really nervous about Herbert's and Gerbert's with all the changes going on. If Herbert's leaves, what am I going to do? Because that's my lunch, my breakfast, my dinner. Like,
right, the whole world might fall apart.
My whole world will fall apart if Herbert's and Gerbert's leaves. But I'm really hoping that doesn't happen. My go-to order is Jacob Bluefinger sub. No cucumbers. I just don't like the texture.
I get it.
And then I take the potato chips, like just the Lay's classic yellow bag potato chips, put it in the sub.
What about like Ruffles? Plain Ruffles? No?
No. It's like, I don't know, it's a texture thing.
No, I get it. I normally get like the half sandwich, half soup with the tappy, no tomatoes, no onions, and then add mayonnaise on it because I'm a fiend for mayonnaise. But the chips and the soda is kind of whatever I'm feeling. And then for the soup, if they hopefully have the broccoli and cheddar, I will get that. But if not, the mac and cheese.
You know what I've been really missing lately? The Mongolian Grill in Drumland.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, I love myself some Mongolian Grill. That was like my dinner, like after practice, I would go to Drumland, I'd get Mongolian Grill. It just is perfect. Like, what am I gonna do if I don't? And it's been gone, and I've been really sad. But I've just been having to have Herbert's because what am I gonna do without the Mongolian Grill? So if Mongolian Grill's gone and Herbert's is gone, what am I gonna
do? What is left? I mean, we have Heat and Fire, which is pretty
delicious. That's true. Those pickle chips are so good. I feel like I really didn't utilize the Down Under until like recently.
Yeah.
But the pizza, the spring rolls. Ooh, the spring rolls are so good. And then the pickle chips.
Don't even get me started on the dilly pickle pizza that they have for the month. When we come back from break, I'm gonna be devastated because that's been my go-to. Like after a long night, what do I settle down for dinner with? A pickle pizza.
It sounds crazy. The pickle pizza is so good, though.
I'd recommend it.
It's so good. Yeah. They have the, like, mac and cheese bites, which are, like, that's something I would have, like, when I was really little, and I've had it. It's just, like, bringing back my childhood. Yeah. It's awesome.
I for sure heard some good things about it.
Coming up on the Whitewater Wind Down, we have an inside look at other campus changes, so don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
What does it mean to be a war hawk?
It means allowing myself to dream big and think outside the box.
Pushing the limits of what I think is possible.
Seeing ideas through from start to finish.
Collaborating with professors and peers.
And seizing opportunities in the community to put my knowledge to use.
I'm studying abroad.
Learning another language.
And listening to the stories of others.
I'm making lifelong friends and fearlessly sharing my gifts with the world.
As a war hawk, I stay balanced,
take great care of myself,
and get out of my comfort zone.
I refuse to let the past determine my future.
And I'm taking confident steps in the direction of my dreams.
Sometimes it doesn't make sense.
And other times it couldn't be more exciting.
But I will keep my goals in mind
and never quit.
Because that...
That's the war hawk way.
UWW-TV has been an important part of the campus and community since 1980.
Not only providing on-air learning opportunities for broadcast journalists and electronic media production students,
but educating and entertaining our audiences with award-winning news, live sports coverage, original programming,
as well as dedicating a mission to developing creative collaborations throughout campus.
For more information, visit our website and like us on Facebook.
Check us out because you gotta see what's on UWW-TV.
The UW-Whitewater Bookstore is your one-stop shop for apparel, textbooks, and technology. Stop in for a wide selection of gifts from our alumni, family, and name brand sections. Need to purchase or rent a textbook? Head downstairs to Textbook Services. Check out our new custom shop and create personalized apparel for your organization. Need a charger, laptop, or headphones? Our new technology section has everything you might need. For more information and bookstore hours, visit uwwhitewaterbookstore.com.
The Department of Communication offers students the opportunity to explore the world through the faculty-led travel study program. The course consists of both in-class lecture and a three-week travel component at the end of the semester.
You have a life that is insanely busy. You don't have to give up so much time to do a three-week travel study, and you can compact a lot in 3 weeks.
The course is worth 3 credits and is open to all majors. The program features group travel with peers and faculty.
I think the benefit of traveling in a group like the travel study is there's always somebody there to experience new things with you, and you always have new friends to gain.
Travel study offers a variety of travel destinations, including a trip to Ireland every other year. Develop new relationships, participate in enriching cultures, and experience personal growth while abroad.
With the travel study, it was so great being able to go to places and really experience the value that they can give to our own culture and just to me as a person.
For more information, please visit.
I recently had the opportunity to visit the multi-purpose mindfulness space in one of the dorm halls. With this, I had the privilege of interviewing an RA and a psychology student about their opinions on the space and how they are impacted by it.
On the week of March 11th, new posters were hung up in resident hallways showcasing the multi-purpose mindfulness spaces, which are the music rooms in dorm buildings that now have a relaxing twist. These rooms are free to use and available to students at any time unless they are already in use. Students are provided an accessible and relaxing environment. As midterms arrive and finals are around the corner, students are thankful for a new, relaxing way to unwind.
So I'm Cindy Fremstead, and I am a student assistant in the psychology department. Being in a place where you study regularly, like your room, if you study in your room a lot, you focus and you stress on your work. So being in here, coloring, relaxing in the beanbag, it's a good way to relax, slowing the brain waves, slowing your body. It reduces the cortisol, which is the stress hormone that your body produces when you're stressed. It reduces cortisol and it increases the serotonin levels in your body, which is happy vibe.
Well, I'm Ayana. I am an RA here on TUT second floor. Mental health as a whole is a very prominent factor on the floor. A lot of people come to me being hey, I just need my own space. Being able to sympathize with people on these issues and being hey. So being able to take a break is something I think a lot of, especially freshmen, struggle with, and just having to be able to find that space of their own. I think it's well worth it to at least even just sit here and just enjoy the chair.
Not every dorm has a multi-purpose mindfulness space, but QR codes are listed on the posters, allowing students to request access to other dorms that have them. Dorms that include these places are Clem, Lee, Tut, and Wells East's music rooms. After filling out the request form, access will be granted within 2 business days. Whether you're feeling stressed or looking for a change of scenery, feel free to check out these rooms to unwind. This has been Edie Fernay for UWW-TV.
Thanks for the package, Edie. Yeah, one of the things that I could really relate to is just needing a space to be completely by yourself, because after a busy day, so much stress, and you just want to go to your room and be alone. But we're college kids, we don't have our own room. And if your roommate's there, you can't kick your roommate out. I love my roommate, but we both just love our alone time. So I can just go into the basement, chill, be by myself. It's great that we have that opportunity out there.
Yeah, it's definitely awesome. As you were saying, I also get along super well with my roommate, but sometimes it's I had a busy day, I don't want to talk to anyone. I don't care who it is, I just want to sit alone, do some coloring, look at my phone, anything really. And my own peace and quiet is very relaxing.
Yeah, so that's great that there's that space available for you guys.
We'll be right back with more on the Whitewater Wind Down. But first, let's take a look at the weekend's weather forecast.
Thank you.
The Royal Purple, the best place for all the latest news around the community and campus of UW-Whitewater. Here you'll find all different types of weekly news stories, including sports, arts and rec, biz and tech, and even fun and interesting things like trendsetter columns and the tweet of the week. The Royal Purple has a full staff to handle all of your advertising and article needs. Ad managers and sales representatives can help you get your ad and seasonal print issues online at royalpurplenews.com and out on our social media platforms. Editors and journalists would love to write features about your organization and follow-ups about your important events. For more information on student employment opportunities, advertisement services, or anything news, contact the Royal Purple over at RP@uww.edu or give us a call at 262-472-5100. Stop by our office and say hi on campus in McCutcheon Hall, room 113. For all of your local campus community news, check out the Royal Purple here at University of Wisconsin-Whitewater.
Here at UWW, we put a lot of emphasis on shaping your involvement. Involvement helps you get to know more people with similar values and goals as yourself. The Student Involvement Office can help you get involved with organizations on campus, or we can help you start a brand new one. So what are you waiting for? It's time to shape your involvement at UWW. If you'd like to learn more, stop by UC127 or contact us at involvement@uww.edu or call 262-472-6217.
I'm Brandon Bozinski, and this is The World Today on UWW-TV. TikTok users flooded Congress in an uproar of anger over the possible ban of the social media platform titled TikTok. Some messages are as extreme as self-harm or threatening to leave the country. An overwhelming bipartisan House majority on Wednesday, March 13th, voted 352-65 to approve Protecting Americans from Foreign Adversary Controlled Applications Act, which would ban TikTok in the United States. The ban will not go through unless ByteDance, its Chinese owner, sells to a non-Chinese company in 6 months. The American government is concerned for its citizens' mental health, as well as private information being collected by foreign governments. SpaceX blasted off another rocket for a test flight after spending thousands of hours upgrading it from the previous test. The goal was to make it halfway around the world. This rocket was the biggest and most powerful rocket yet. It took off from the southern tip of Texas and traveled over the Gulf of Mexico. No one was on board, and it was never intended to leave Earth's atmosphere. The first two test flights from SpaceX lasted about 2 minutes before blowing up. This rocket from SpaceX, made by Elon Musk, outperformed NASA's past and present rockets. The goal of this project is to land astronauts on the moon in the next 2 years. Akira Toriyama, creator of the popular manga Dragon Ball, has passed away at the age of 68. His work sold millions of copies, inspiring television, film, and video game adaptations. Throughout his career, he was said to take care intensely about the fans of his work, and his main goal was to entertain them. His many other works are continuing to blossom, as one in specific, Sandland, which is set to release as an anime on Disney Plus later this spring, along with a video game. Fans of his work are exceptionally thankful for him and will continue to influence pop culture long after his passing. For more updates, check us out at uwwtv.org. I'm Brandon Bozinski, and this has been The World Today on UWW-TV.
To show you what it's like to be a Warhawk.
Come on!
Don't miss out on your chance to be a Warhawk
at UW-Whitewater.
You belong here!
Video One Media Services provides accomplished students the opportunity to enhance their college experience by working with real-world clients. In addition, we provide clients local and affordable video options to better enhance their media needs. For more information on how Video One Media Services can help you with your next media project, email or call our office at 262-472-5659.
Bonsoir à tous.
Hola.
Hey, hur är läget?
Marhaba.
Ni hao.
Konnichiwa.
UW-Whitewater International Student Association is a student organization that brings both international students and national students together to share their cultural experience and beliefs. The ISA also collaborates with other student organizations in UW-Whitewater. The International Dinner is one of the most unique events that ISA have for every spring semester, which serves all kinds of food from different countries, and it invites students to show their talent on a dinner. So what are you waiting for? Come join the ISA today.
We are ISA.
This week on the Whitewater Wind Down, we have a segment called Weird News, where we talk about unique news stories.
A woman from Nebraska stole over $27,000 in fuel after discovering a flaw in the system. Dawn Thompson was allegedly able to swipe her rewards card twice instead of swiping a credit or debit card, allowing her to get free gas. Thompson stole about 7,500 gallons of gas over a six-month period. She is now facing a felony theft charge.
Dutch supermarket Jumbo introduced the concept of chat corners, which are rapidly growing and influencing other grocers. Chat corners are slower checkouts that enable the cashier and the customer to leisurely chat throughout the checkout process. They are said to help loneliness, especially with older individuals.
Wisconsin pig named Kevin Bacon was caught wandering around Kenosha County. The pig ended up in a couple's backyard and was given many snacks before taking photos with the county sheriff and being escorted back to his pen.
Three boxes of toilet paper clogged a California highway, leading police to block off two lanes of traffic. Officers were throwing rolls of toilet paper to the side of the road for around 20 minutes before the lanes could be used. I thought one of the funniest stories was the one that I read about the grocery store situation, like the slower checkouts, which is actually really cute because my first job was at a grocery store, and like I remember when older people would come into my checkout and they would just be chatting it up and like, because they don't really get people to talk to. So I think that it's cute. Also, checkouts, it's a lot of pressure to be fast. So
I know, especially when I did checkout at my previous job. It was so stressful. People would be like, hurry up. And I was like, I'm sorry, I don't know. So I feel like giving both people time is pretty important. And I know I'd be thankful as a worker to be like, okay, this person wants me to take my time, so I will. And I won't feel bad about it. And the other story taking place in Kenosha with Kevin Bacon. I've never seen a pig when I've lived in Kenosha. I've seen like a turkey and a chicken, but that's about it. I wish I could have been there to see that.
Yeah, it's always cool when you see stories about your hometown. Like, I remember I was scrolling on TikTok and I saw a video about like a New London like pizza restaurant. And I was like, hey, that's news about my town. Like, it's always weird when that happens.
Yeah.
So that was cool to see. Kevin Bacon, the celebrity of Kenosha.
My roommate's from a small town and she was super excited when she saw a news report about her town getting a Taco Bell.
I know, it's crazy. Yeah. Those small town situations are so fun.
Yeah, for sure. And the teepee on the tracks, oh my gosh, pretty crazy.
Okay, so when I'm driving, I have no patience. Like, when there's traffic, I'm like so mad. Cause it's like a 2.5 hour, 3 hour depending drive, like back home, and there's traffic. I'm like, I hope there's not an accident, but like, I wanna go home.
Yeah.
So I feel like if I was on that road driving, I would just be laughing. I'd be like, I was so angry just about this toilet paper. Like, I don't know, it's kind of funny.
Yeah, they had to take like each individual roll and throw it.
I know,
that was
just
pretty
like
comical.
Throwing the toilet paper off of the road. That's so funny.
I mean, what can you do though, you know? After the break, we'll take a look at this week in Wisconsin history to learn about Joshua Glover. Stay tuned for more on the Whitewater Windup.
WSUW, 91.7 is a student-run radio station serving the Whitewater area with a variety of original programs, live sports broadcasting, community events, and more. So turn us on, 91.7 FM, or stream us live at 917theedge.com.
Welcome to Jitters Coffee House. Located on the first floor of the Wells Towers, Jitters is a student-run coffee lounge and offers a variety of coffee and ice cream-based drinks and is home to many entertaining programs, including live music, gamer trivia nights, and other performances. Coordinate your activity by emailing jitters@uww.edu. Jitters is completely run by volunteers who can earn service hours and even receive a free drink during their shift. Stop in tonight at Jitters Coffee House, where fun events and community come together.
Welcome to the Anderson Library, a destination that offers many things to students and other people.
At the library, there's a whole host of resources that you have support for your academics in terms of books, databases, other resources that streaming videos that you're going to use for classes.
And we do pet therapy once a week, alternating Mondays and Tuesdays. So that is something that any and all students, staff, and community members can come in and join us for.
Well, on the main floor of the library, we have a big chess set. So that's pretty popular to have students come in, play chess. People get really into it. You can reserve a study room, or if it's just you're looking for something fun to do on the weekend, you can come check out our video games or our board games.
You can also come check out and get a snack at their cafe. There is plenty of things to do at the Anderson Library besides just studying. For more information about the library's events and other topics, go to uww.edu/library.
Welcome to This Week in Wisconsin History. This week, we'll be covering the 1854 capture and subsequent rescue of escaped slave Joshua Glover. On the evening of Friday, March 10th, 1854, mill worker Joshua Glover was playing cards with his friends when a group of armed men stormed into his cabin and attempted to arrest him. Leading the group was Benamee S. Garland, a Missouri slaveholder who purchased Glover 4 years prior. Glover escaped Garland's plantation in 1852. Trekking over 350 miles to settle in Racine, a staunch abolitionist town in the free state of Wisconsin. Garland later learned of Glover's new location and acquired a certificate of removal and a warrant for his escaped slave's arrest under the Fugitive Slave Act of 1850, then set off to retrieve Glover from Wisconsin. The arresting party repeatedly beat Glover before securing him with manacles and tossing his bleeding, half-conscious body into a wagon. Glover's captors then set out for Milwaukee, hoping for a quick hearing and a discreet removal of the fugitive to Missouri with little to no trouble from Wisconsin's abolitionists. However, news of Glover's capture and imprisonment in a Milwaukee jail soon spread from Racine, reaching outspoken abolitionist newspaper editor Sherman M. Booth early Saturday morning. Booth and a group of other local anti-slavery advocates and lawyers immediately began working to release Glover. Booth rode his horse through nearby streets proclaiming, "A man's liberty is at stake," and that any freed man opposed to slavery gathered outside the courthouse for a public meeting. A crowd of around 4,000 people assembled in the square, listening to impassioned speeches from the local abolitionists condemning Glover's arrest and detainment under the Fugitive Slave Act. Upon hearing the judge's decision to postpone Glover's hearing to Monday and keep the badly beaten Glover imprisoned with no medical treatment, the crowd was outraged and decided to take matters into their own hands. A heavy wooden beam retrieved from the nearby construction site of St. John's Cathedral was used by the crowd as a battering ram, along with axes to break down the door to Glover's cell. Once freed, the crowd escorted Glover through Milwaukee streets before reaching the Walker's Point Bridge, where a local businessman offered up his own buggy to transport Glover out of the city. With the raise of his cap to the cheering crowd, Joshua Glover was on his way to freedom once again. Glover was able to escape to Canada just 1 month after his rescue, living the rest of his life there as a free man. His rescue contributed to a growing statewide resistance against the Fugitive Slave Act leading up to the Civil War. In defiance of federal law, Wisconsin Supreme Court would be the only high state court to declare the Fugitive Slave Act unconstitutional before its official repeal in 1864. A And that's what happened this week in Wisconsin history.
Spring break starts Friday. So, Edie, what are your spring break plans?
I'm probably just going to be hanging out with my boyfriend and my family a lot because all the other schools that I know of, the colleges, have different spring breaks than us. So a lot of my friends who go to UW-Milwaukee are already on break. So I'm like, I can't really see them, which is kind of unfortunate.
Yeah, my high school friends go to UW-Green Bay and UW-La Crosse, and they already had spring break like 2 weeks ago. So I know, like once I go home, it's not like I can really hang out with my other friends.
Yeah.
But one of my friends does have her 20th birthday party, so I'm hoping just to like go back, hang out with some people I haven't seen since Christmas break, which is always a weird experience, but it's really nice when you can just pick up where you left off with people. But hopefully I can go on a little mini vacation this spring break, so looking forward to that.
For sure. Well, it looks like that is all the time that we're going to have on this edition of the Whitewater Wind Down. Thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next week for more news and entertainment. From Peyton and myself, have a fantastic week and spring break. Don't forget to stay tuned to UWW-TV.